continue the Shulam Tefillah. We were by the Vitur, which is Hashem Lo Bakechnu. Now we're going to go to Gimel. Gimel, Gazan. Gazan, we rob. We rob people. We have Genevo and Gesela. Genevo means the sneaky way at night. Person is afraid of people, is not afraid of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Gesela means robber. Robber comes with a weapon. Not afraid of Hashem, and not afraid of people. But they say, in a way, Gesela is much better than Genevo. But the worst type of the Geneva is when a person steals, the girl says, Baba Kama, there are seven types of Ganov, seven types of thieves. And then the Gemara says, the highest thief is somebody is stealing the doubt of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the knowledge of Hashem. Makes HaKadosh Baruch Hu that he has a knowledge as if he doesn't have knowledge. He goes and against people and talks to people in a way, in a very sneaky way, that people don't realize, but Hashem realizes. Stealing the doubt of Hashem is the worst type of sin. Ibanu Dofi, we spoke ugly things, Lashon Hara, and gossip. Ibanu Dofi, Lashon Hara. Lashon Hara means that saying anything negative about somebody else, that when he hears about that, he feels bad about it. Pensing, or he has a loss of money, whatever that is, the person that talks against him, that's Lashon Hara. People feel Lashon Hara is something that you have to climb mountains to say Lashon Hara. Anything, if somebody different tells you something that you should not tell other people, or anything that when the person that you talked about hears about that, and he would be annoyed that you said that, it feels, makes him feel bad, or makes him look bad, that's Lashon Hara. And the Gemara says that the Chuban Rabbat Amidosh happened through Lashon Hara, until now is Lashon Hara. Somebody was telling me, how did he stop Lashon Hara from home? One time he came home from the work and he wanted to eat supper, whatever, and it was ready. Somebody said Lashon Hara at home. And he said, this Lashon Hara that was said was like a poison. I can't eat. I was fed poison here. And you know, I cannot eat. And through that, make that understanding that Lashon Hara is so chamor, it's such a machloket, such a distraction, and such a painful thing. I'm not recommending that because that's not so the very it's a drastic act to be done. But I just want to bring out the point when you introduce Lashon Hara to be bigger and to be something that you know have to stay away. And the best model is, best thing is, instead of doing that, the best thing is to educate family. When you are together on Shabbat or any meal, to learn Sefer about Lashon Hara. Through that, everybody becomes educated that Lashon Hara is not good, and that's the cause of the Churban. Now, Chachamim tell us, as long as we are not building the Beit HaMikdash, we are destroying it. To build that Beit HaMikdash, we just have to remove the cause of the Churban, the Lashon Hara. Lashon Hara is the Churban. Once we could stop the Lashon Hara, we stop the Churban. Hevinu means making things wrong. Everything I was wrong with you, that's Yashar straight. But you know, willingly, we do things to go wrong. And that's Hevinu that says, hey, Vav the Hishanu, and we did acted wickedness. And the Ishanu Vav, very interesting in Vav, but for Vav, we don't use a verb that starts with Vav. We use the Vav of Achibur, connection. Roshim say, why do we use the Vav of connection, not the Vav of a verb to start with Vav? Because one of the things that you are admitting Vav of connection. We connected Averot together. That in itself is part of the admission. But admitting HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but on one Avera, we went to another Avera. Zatnu, we did it purposely, not strictly, not accidental. We intended to do the same. Chamasmi means there's a love in Torah, Tachmos. So Tachmos means that we didn't pay wages to a worker properly. We didn't give it to him. But when you steal something, you take some money from somebody with your hand. But when somebody works for you and you have to pay him, you don't pay him. You didn't take away something. Right? That's love of the tachmos. Person, anybody that works for a person and the person doesn't pay him completely, and takes away the money from me. Always pay the worker even more. Don't make sure that the worker should be paid. You connected ourselves to lie and tricks. In other words, we could have been straight and met truthfully. We said a joke, we connected ourselves to Shaker, and you know, we put things under the carpet. Through that, we went through. You asked for a we gave advice, bad advice. In other words, whenever that somebody comes to you, if you are biased, you have to tell him that I cannot advise you. I'm biased, you have to tell him. But a lot of times in life, we give a lot of advice. We give advice to friends, to family. Now, moreover, in the video that we say on the Meserecho, they say, you ask yourself, Belicheker. We add Belicheker. What does Belicheker mean? Without number. In other words, sin that in Elul we say that we do consciously and there's no number for it. It's adyatsu. I was thinking, why? Why this Avera? We don't do this Avera so much. We're not consulting people to give them advice. And I realized every occasion of life that we need advice. We need advice to our wife, to our children, to our friends. And then we are here, advice the halacha says, you have to be very careful to keep it in a way that's good for the other person. If somebody is selfish and self-centered and gives advice to others, to his wife and his children, for his own benefit, it's not doing right. If she wants an advice from you, what's the right thing to do? First, has to make sure to say something that's good for everybody. Some child asks something, your son asks, your daughter, you're lazy, or you don't want to do it, but best for him or for her is something else. That is etzorah. Etzorah, a person should give right advice to right people. Once somebody wanted to take somebody from the yeshiva for a position, the principal came and asked the yeshiva, who is the good? He said that this person is the best candidate for this. Get him. And then he went and talked to him, and then he came back to yeshiva. That person came to the yeshiva, said that I was offered such a job. The yeshiva says, don't take it. He said, okay, I don't take it. Then the principal went back to that person and told him that this comes, you know, I'm not going to survive because Roshiva told me not to go. He went back to Roshiva. He said, Roshiva, you told me that I should take this person. This person comes to us, asks you, say, don't go. How does it work? Says, the halacha is that they have to give right advice to each person accordingly. You need a teacher or somebody you need is the best candidate. I have to tell you that. That's my advice to you. But when I'm facing you, I have to see what's best for you. And then he came to me and he asked me, should I go or not? It's the best for him not to go right now. Therefore, each person, we have to advise properly, accordingly. So we cannot mix things. Everybody has his own right. I have to tell you what's good for you, and I have to tell him what's good for him. Because each one has to get his right advice. From here, we learn out how humble it is whenever that you are biased. Or you feel that you cannot give honest advice, you have to tell the person, see, I'm biased here, and I cannot give you right advice to you, and you should go and get advice from somebody else.